In the last video, we saw how we can add our JavaScript code to our index.html. In this video, we are going to discuss about the HTML file path, how to add different images from different sources to our web page. So let's head over to our Atom Text Editor. So this is how we left in the last video. Hit enter. And let's add an image tag here. Let's add a new tab and let's visit pixabay.com in our browser. It's taking a bit of time. I think my internet is a bit slow. Now it's working fine. So let's use some image from here. Let's use this phishing image from here. Just copy the image link and paste it in the source of your image tag, source attribute of your image tag. Paste it here. Now save it and now refresh it. We'll get this image here. The image is not totally responsive, like it is not occupying the full width. We'll do some changes into our image tag. We'll add some attribute, we'll make it width 200%. So the image always occupies the 100% width of our screen rather than just occupying 200% of our screen or 50% of our screen depending on the device previews. So let's split the screen into two equal parts just like we had before. So when you maximize the screen, the image size decreases and increases according to the screen size. That is what we call responsive image. So we have a source here which has the link to the image from pixabay.com. Let's comment it out as online image. Access. We are accessing the image from the internet. What if we wanted to access the image offline? For that, we need to download the image from pixabay.com. Just comment it out as offline image access and online image access. So it will be easy for you to understand the code when you open this after a week or something. So let's go down and let's discover more. You can use any of the image. I will use which I like. So let's use this hot air balloon. It's really hot. So let's copy. So let's download this 1920 into 12820 and just click on this. I'm not a robot, and just complete this survey. So I'm not a robot now, so let's download it. Open the file location, show in folder, and just cut this from here, or you can copy, it too. So let's copy it from here and go to your desktop and paste it inside your professor of folder. And paste it here. Okay, let's make a new folder first. Let's make it images. So it's like we can access all the images of our web page in a single folder, that is images. So let's paste it here, Control V, and rename it by pressing function F2. Let's make it hot balloon. Make it hot balloon. We'll use camel spacing here. So let's split our screen again and go into a professor of folder. So look, we have got this image inside our images folder, inside our professor of folder. So let's cancel this image. So let's add an image tag here by hitting some spaces here. So let's add image tag, which is source. So we are already inside the professor of folder. We need to go inside the images folder, then we need to access the JPG file, that is the image file. So we'll first access image here, images folder here, images slash, then we are accessing the hotballoon.jpg because we are already inside the professor folder. So we're gonna write hotballoon.jpg. Okay, so let's close it and scroll left. Oh, I added this in the alt tags, alt attribute. So let's paste it inside our source attribute. Alt is basically the secondary text we are gonna show if the image is not displayed properly. So let's cancel this and maximize our screen. I got this image here, but let's add some height to it properties to it. So let's make it look like the fishing image here. Make it width to 100%. Let's keep it 100%. Now refresh it. We'll get the image resolution has same as the fishing image. The image is completely responsive to the width of the screen. That is, width is 100%. So let's scroll left and let's cut it from here and paste it in our professor folder. Let me show you the different way of accessing your images and paste it inside a professor folder. Now the image folder will be empty. Yeah, it's empty right now, and we have this hotballoon.jpg inside our professor folder directly. So to access that hotballoon.jpg, look, now when we refresh it, we don't get any image here because we are going into the images folder and there is no hotballoon.jpg file. So this much is enough for this video. I will see you in the next video with more awesome content. Till then, bye bye, take care.